faith, it really is the core of Croatia. And here in the capital city of Zagreb, it is evident from the way people treat each other, very courteous and following the rules, to even the landscape where the city center is built around the cathedral. And of course, near every cathedral, you will find a market. But not just where city and life come together, it's also where people enjoy themselves, because they know that in order for you to practice their faith, they have to make sure that people know how to live and to live with joy. And that's why coming into an old city in an old country, you see a lot of newness. And what's really impressive is that younger people, the younger generation, they are returning to their traditions. And why? Because it's beautiful, and it's what makes Croatia, at its core, Catholic. One of the things you can't miss, but you need an appointment to see it, is the treasury of the Cathedral of Zagreb. And one of the principal scholars for the history of Zagreb is Sister Lena, who's dedicated her life, 30 years. She's been a teacher, she's been a custodian of the faith, but more importantly, she is a sister who knows how not only to preserve the faith, but to share it with all of the people who are willing to make a trek up these stairs into one of the greatest treasuries that Zagreb has to offer. Sister, how long have you been working in this cathedral?
Yes, kao riznicar, kao riznica Zagrebačke katedrale I radim već 30 godina. I tu sam, evo, I primamo posjete, samo najavljene jer je mali prostor, a također I čuvamo, uređujemo, a I također dajemo za velike svečanosti, za liturgijske upotrebe, kao što smo sad imali relikvijar blaženog Alojzija Stepinca za naše zagrebačko hodočašće u Mariju Bisticu.
What's the most famous relic or piece of treasury that's contained here?
Sama riznica je najvredniji prostor I mini muzej crkveni, jer su iz riznice nastale sve važne ustanove, od prosvjetnih, visokoškolskih, kulturnih, glazbenih. I tu je u samom ovom prostoru bio Hrvatski državni arhiv sve do 1850. godine. A tu su nam I predmeti kao vrijednosti od samog osnivanja Zagrebačke nadbiskupije prije 900 godina, kao što je Ladislavov plašt iz 11. stoljeća, koji je obnovljen u Švicarskoj prije 30 godina. Tu je također I plenari bjelokosni kojeg je dobio sa sobom prvi biskup Duh se zvao I taj plenari je služio kao relikvijar sa česticom Svetoga križa.
And when you receive visitors, what's the most powerful message you can give to them about the treasury?
Pa baš sam ove godine najviše naglašavala pobjedu, jer tu imamo I zastavu, našu bansku državnu, najstariju sačuvanu. Bilo je starije, ali mi imamo najstariju sačuvanu u čitavoj Hrvatskoj. Pa sam, pošto je taj naš hrvatski ban bio I pobjednik, najviše sam govorila o pobjedi. A to mi se nekako tako složilo, pa smo imali onda I nogometnu pobjedu ove godine.
every family needs a mother, and even though we call her Sister Lena, she is really a mother of faith because she's a custodian, a protector, a curator of all the valuable things that Croatia's Catholicism has to offer, from the chalices that hold the precious blood, even to the relics of the Holy Innocents in Bethlehem. All of this is connecting us to the deeper experience of culture and Croatia's core, which is the Catholic faith. And just leaving the treasury leads to this magnificent cathedral where we're going to meet Father Borna, who's going to talk a little bit about the history and also pay homage to Blessed Stepinac. A brief history of the construction of this cathedral.
As always in Europe, when you see a cathedral, you just see what you can see right now. But it's usually a cathedral that incorporates a lot of the prior cathedrals. For example, the construction of this cathedral started in the 11th century, because we know that the Archdiocese of Zagreb was founded as his diocese in 1094. And immediately after the foundation of the diocese, they wanted to build a cathedral. So the first part of this cathedral is from the 11th century. But of course, there would be new improvements, and some of them would be demolished. For example, in Zagreb, there was a huge invasion of a Tatar tribe in the 14th century, so they demolished the cathedral. So the old Romanic cathedral was replaced by the Gothic one, and then there was a Baroque style cathedral. And right now, what we are looking at the Neo-Gothic cathedral that was constructed after a huge earthquake that struck Zagreb in the 1880. So in the 19th century. So there was a big work of reconstruction of the Cathedral of Zagreb done by two famous architects from Austria, actually, and they built this beautiful Neo-Gothic cathedral in the 1880s.
And tell me a little bit about the great tomb of Cardinal Stepinac.
Cardinal Aloysius, or Aloysius Stepinac, is, as St. John Paul II said, the greatest and the most important figure of the Croatian Catholic Church in the 20th century, but probably in our Croatian Catholic history. He was nominated the youngest bishop at the time, when he was nominated the coadjutor of the Archbishop of Zagreb in the 1932. He was born in 1898 in a small village near Zagreb, and he studied in Rome. Then he became ordinary of the Archdiocese of Zagreb, and he founded Caritas. He did a lot of pastoral activity, pastoral work. He founded a lot of what are today most important parishes for Archdiocese. But then what happened is this terrible, terrible period of the Second World War. He was against racial persecution. He helped a lot of Jews. He helped a lot of people who were persecuted. And then after the Second World War, when the communists took power in Croatia, he remained the same, close to his people, but especially close to the Holy See, close to the Holy Father, because, for example, as in other parts of the world, the communists would offer him to be a leader of some kind of national church. But of course, he said, "I cannot deal with you about that. You should speak with Rome. I'm just a bishop and servant, a pastor of a Catholic church, and I want to be obedient and faithful to Rome." So Cardinal Aloysius Stepinac is blessed because he's a martyr in obedience to the church and to the Holy See. He basically was trialed, persecuted, and he was for many years suffered the persecution in a prison. So he died as a martyr.
And when people come as pilgrims and as visitors, What do you want people to walk away with when they leave the cathedral?
I always say to the people, especially to the tourists, look closely, you will see a cathedral which is really a place of prayer. You will always see people praying, you will see people going to confession. Actually, our cathedral is a big confessional. We have confessions every day. So what I always say to people, this is a place of God, a place for prayer, for rest, and for spiritual renewal.
Any good traveler or pilgrim will tell you, if you want to know the history of the city, go to the places of worship. And for the Catholics who are masters at record keeping, you can go to any cathedral and get layers and layers of history. And one of the most beautiful things about the Zagreb Cathedral is the fact that the history has always been connected and faithful to the Holy See, the Holy Roman Pontiff, and Rome. Blessed Cardinal Stepinac shows how he was so faithful to Rome and to uphold the mission to protect the dignity of human life. And while he was caught up in a lot of political turmoil, the records show that this was a man of God using his authority and his title to protect people of all races, of all religions, and of all backgrounds. This is the reason why a place like the cathedral dedicated to the Assumption of the Blessed Mother is truly a mother church for the people of Croatia. Because when you come to a place like this, you are part of God's family. That was a beautiful cathedral. And I love the fact that the bells are telling us it's time for lunch.
It is, of course.
And that's why we've got to get our way to that market and get some Chivape. Cheers. So this is the Chivape.
Benedi Domine nos et qui tuam vada, tua lade sumus motori per Christum Dominum nostrum. Amen. God bless you and...
God bless you. This almost has like the essence of kind of like a shawarma. So what we've got here is this ivar, which is a red pepper cream, like a paste, basically, of red peppers. This is so savory. This has a smoky sweetness to it. It's delicious. And this one's a white cream, you're saying?
Yeah, it's a white cream.
It looks like mayonnaise, but it's not. No, it's what is it? What is it called?
Is it kaimak?
Kaimak. Okay. Kaimak. Yeah. Here we go.
Yeah, try it.
It's garlicky. Tastes like an aioli. A type of a mayonnaise infused with some garlic and spices. I don't care what you call it, it's delicious. Ground veal, onions, simple flavors, kind of filled with a lot of, I would call natural spices, too.
You see, it's very simple food.
Yeah, very simple food. Oh, yeah. Now, Father, I'm going to be going to Maria Bistrica.
Bistrica, exactly.
I can't wait. So much more about Zagreb, reaching out to even the northern part of Croatia. The faith is strong here in Croatia.
It is, yeah. Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. This statue shows the traditional women of Croatia bringing the harvest of the earth, the fruit of the vine, the fruit of the earth, and carrying it on their head. Really, it's a perfect image of our Blessed Mother who carried the fruit of the vine in her womb, the blessed fruit of her womb. And as the women of Croatia love to feed their children, we know our Blessed Mother loves to feed all of God's children, which is why our next stop is going to be at a place called the Shrine of Maria Bistrica, and it's going to be in the northern part of Croatia where the faith continues to grow. Every country has a shrine, if they're a Catholic country, that's dedicated to our Blessed Mother in honor, obviously, of Jesus. And we are here at Maria Bistrica, and we're going to meet Sister Berislava, who's going to explain why this is part of the heart of the Croatian people. What is this view that we're overlooking behind me?
It's an area of Hrvatsko Zagorje. It means an area behind the hills. It's behind the hills, it's a kind of hinterland of Zagreb. The shrine was here since 15th century, but was in a small chapel on a hill. And during the danger of a Turk army, a parish priest brought it here. And later it developed to a shrine.
And what did the parish bring? The statue of the Blessed Mother?
Statue, it's a Black Madonna. One of famous Black Madonnas, miraculous Black Madonnas from Middle Ages in Europe.
And what is it that you want the pilgrims to experience when they come here?
I want them to experience it, Mother of God who's with them. They feel usually as a children here, and they got strengthened in their faith. They get some strength, some encouragement in their life. It's very common to come here at least once in a year to pray for their family, to make decisions. It's a beautiful place and it means a lot to us. Here, Pope John Paul II proclaimed Blessed Cardinal Stepinac. And it's also so one reason to make this place so special.
Everyone at Maria Bistrița, the minor basilica and the sanctuary, kept telling me I've got to get the medinyatsi, these sugar cookies, honeyed, sweetened cookies, but I didn't want to ruin my appetite, even though it's a nationally protected recipe, because we're going back to Zagreb and I'm going to go to Terraca Mihita for some delicious food, a great lunch, meet the people there. But sister, she was mentioning the spirituality. Things always go round and round, but faith keeps us rooted. And that's kind of the deeper message that I'm getting from the people, the pilgrim people of Croatia. They're constantly looking for that eternal foundation, that anchor that keeps them in faith when everything just keeps going round and round. Right in the city of Zagreb, this is our final stop. We're gonna be at Terraca Mihita, the owner Ivan and his family. This guy's amazing, car dealer, realtor, and he has started other businesses, and he wants to start a restaurant to keep his family together and to show how Croatia is truly a global country. And here we're gonna be tasting some global cuisine. And I know, oh, here we are. Pour up some wine, brother. What is this called? It's a Chardonnay. Good way to start our meal here at Terraca Mihita. Cheers. Oh yeah, that'll work. So they even house cure some of their own charcuterie. They source the local cheeses here. They bake their own bread in this oven. Super delicious, super global. Very much a surprise from what you would think is traditional food in Croatia. But these are people reaching out to the global hungers. And you know what? There's a lot of delicious food out in this world, including this stuff. And here is the čobanec soup. I love this. It's very stewish, almost guyashi in a way, but it's obviously got their own meat, as well as veal, as well as some pork. They made their own noodles, and then they even got their spring onions, and they braised it, and they grilled it, and it all came from Maria Bistrița, that whole area. So this is gonna be really fun for me to kind of taste the soup first. Oh man, little bit of the spice that's coming in from just the stew itself. You know, they love their peppers in this area, so one composed bite. Again, this could be a meal in and of itself. Oh man. It's delicious. So, I'm not gonna even drink anything right now, I'm gonna keep eating. I've got Chef Bruno in the kitchen, the executive chef. Let me tell you, your charcuterie, some of that house cured and house made, delicious, and your stew, very flavorful, a kind of a nod to international goulash, yes. So close to Hungary.
Yes.
But now I'm excited to eat your duck.
Thank
Sounds
you very
funny,
much.
But this is a fresh duck, right?
Fresh duck, yes, yes.
All right, so tell me, what do you call it in Croatian?
We call it in Croatian just roasted duck with some seasoning and fresh herbs and a little bit of orange.
All right, let's see you make it.
Yes. We have this fresh duck, lovely duck. We just use a little bit of sea salt on the top.
Yep.
Put a little bit salt inside.
All right, so salt and got some pepper.
Salt, a little bit outside, not too much.
Not too much.
Not too much.
Yeah.
But much
on the
inside.
On the inside, yep.
There it is.
I also cut the oranges, people, okay?
Then you use fresh thyme.
And
it's
this,
very good for the
this
duck.
This thyme came from Maria Bistrița area,
yes,
right?
Yes, so
we
is the duck.
Just there.
So is the duck.
And so is the duck.
Yes.
Wow, see, the Blessed Mother provides. Go for it.
Just put it in, and from Chef Leos, orange.
That's right.
For
nice.
Duck this size, you need two orange.
You need two.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely.
And
cavity
sometime.
Up more, exactly.
Yes, to cavity up, yes.
He's gonna score it, good.
Yes.
And this helps to render the fat out of it to help make it extra crispy.
Yes.
Because that's what we want, crispy skin.
Yes.
Into the oven it goes.
Put it in the oven.
All right.
That's
and
perfect.
Then how long does this take in the oven?
We roast it about 2.5 hours.
I'm gonna have to do some praying for patience. So while the duck is cooking, and I'm kind of excited,
yes.
You're gonna be making a traditional dish called mlinci.
That is like side dish.
A side dish, all
for
right?
For roasted ducks.
Perfect for roasted duck.
Yes. So we have the boiled water.
Yep.
Just put it in. You just need it to...
To soak.
To soak, yes.
Yep. So
that
this is some very crusty bread. Maybe a day old or something, or?
You can put it also if you have 1 month old.
1 month old
no
bread?
Problem. Yes.
Wow.
Just
and
soaked
then
it
a
up.
Little bit of water, we're gonna baptize the bread, and then we are going to anoint the bread with some of the duck fat, and this is mlinci.
Yes.
There we go.
When you mix it up, you can heat the pan and put a little bit of duck fat.
Just okay. A little bit of duck fat.
Yes.
Just a little bit of duck fat. I like this guy.
A little bit of pepper in the fat. And I think the mlinci is it's good.
What's the bread called? Mlinci?
Yes.
I have never seen this before.
Put the heat off.
Let it soak the
Let
fat.
Let it soak the fat, yes.
This is a very healthy dish.
For winter.
For winter.
When you need more energy. I think that is good. I can put it off.
Okay. And then...
Just let it soak it
just
up.
Just let it soak? Okay,
yes.
I'm gonna soak this up.
Yes.
Okay,
a little bit of pepper and a little bit of salt.
Okay.
It's good.
It kind of...
It's good.
Tossed around.
Yes.
All right. This is really cool, actually. And then at this stage, I think your duck is done, right?
Yes.
Beautiful.
It's good smells.
Yeah.
Yes.
Smells so good. I think it's the oranges that I cut.
You just put out the orange that you made inside and we just carve it.
All right.
The meat is very tender. You
yeah,
see?
You're gonna cut that little piece off there so I can taste that.
This is good.
Tender, fresh, and not gamey. Not at all. Okay, so he's gonna separate the cavity out from the breast to the thigh. Mlinci. Up! So this is basically a stuffing that they made, but separated it out. You're gonna get all the flavors from the duck fat. But you didn't have to cook it inside, which would have actually prolonged the cooking time. Oh, that's beautiful.
Some more pepper. There you go.
Chef Bruno's duck à l'orange, Zagreb style.
Bon appetit.
I am so honored to be eating in this amazing restaurant with the owners for about 15 years?
15 years.
15 years. We've got Ivan and Irena. And tell me the names of your beautiful children.
Maria.
Vladimir. Petar.
Ivan. Yes.
And who's this little guy?
This is Mikhail.
Mikhail.
Okay, so Irena, who's your favorite child? I'm kidding, don't answer that question. Because they are all so beautiful. Now, you've owned this restaurant for 15 years.
Yes, yes. We started the business 15 years ago, and our mission is preparing the food from the natural...
ingredients?
Yeah, ingredients,
yeah.
Yes. And I think that will be something what is good for my family and for my customers. It will be very good experience to eat in that restaurant.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh my gosh, I am so excited for this duck and the mlinsi. Is that how you call it?
Yes.
Mlinsi, and you cook this, right?
Yes.
You cook this at home. I'm gonna bless this food. I'm gonna give it a taste test. But let me ask you, you know, you've got a beautiful family here and you're still together. You must be proud of your family. Yeah, obviously. And then when people come to this restaurant, what do you want them to experience? What are you proud of with this restaurant?
Yes, prvenstveno ja sam ponosan na svoju obitelj i na naše zajedništvo, a to pokušavamo prenijeti na naše goste i na naše osoblje, da oni također osjete tu jednu toplinu i ljubav koju smo uložili i u ovaj restoran i u hranu koju nudimo. I nadamo se da će se to sa vremenom poznati. Već 15 godina smo mi u tome poslu i za sada je to uspješan obiteljski posao i evo, s Božijom pomoći ja vjerujem da ćemo i dalje nastaviti, da će ta naša ljubav i zajedništvo koje ulažemo da će se vidjeti u našem restoranu.
What you just described, I can see why you're a proud man, hardworking dude, from a realtor to a car dealer.
Yes.
And then now this restaurant for 15 years and of course a beautiful family and a cute little grandson. Right there. There he is. And let me tell you, this mlinsi, that's delicious.
Yes.
It's so good. And the duck itself is so fresh.
Speciality for this area, Croatia, is around Zagreb. It's Zagorje. The speciality is from Zagorje.
I love it. I am learning so much about Croatia, about Zagreb, and about the core of who you people are. You are faithful foodies. Thank Delicious.
You. Thank you. Enjoy.
I visited Croatia 30 years ago. It is here where I, in part, received my vocation to the priesthood. And then just coming back and learning even more about their culture, I'm just so moved by the devotion of the people that even though life continues to spin around and you get dizzy sometimes, they're all walking around the one stable thing in life, and that's Mary's yes to doing God's will. I just think that one of the reasons why I think God called me back to Croatia 30 years later is to remind me of who these people are at a core. They are a family, and they are of a family of faith. I can't wait another 30 years to come back.